everyone. This is Dr. Adel Bondok, Professor of Anatomy and Neuroscience, Mansoura University, Egypt. I will talk about the muscles of the back and the muscles of the shoulder region. Start by the muscles of the back. Muscles of the back are divided into two layers. Superficial layer, two muscles, and the deep layer, three muscles. The superficial layer, trapezius and latissimus dorsi. The deep layer, from above downward, levator scapulae, rhomboid minor, and rhomboid major. So the five muscles of the back are two superficial layer, trapezius and latissimus dorsi, and the three deep layer, levator scapulae, rhomboid minor, and rhomboid major. Regarding the superficial layer, trapezius and latissimus dorsi, we'll talk about the origin and insertion. Trapezius takes a linear origin. This is a linear origin from the superior nuchal line and external occipital protuberance, from the ligamentum nuchae, from the seventh cervical spine, and from all thoracic spines. The latissimus dorsi also has a linear origin, start from the inferior angle of the scapula, okay, the lower six thoracic spines, the lumbar fascia or thoracolumbar fascia, iliac crest, and the last three ribs. The trapezius is inserted into the clavicle, the acromion, and the spine of the scapula. Clavicle, acromion, and the spine of the clavicle. The latissimus dorsi is inserted into the floor of the bicipital groove. So now we have three muscles inserted into the bicipital groove. Regarding the nerve supply and action, trapezius is supplied by the spinal accessory nerve. Latissimus dorsi is supplied by the thoracodorsal nerve or nerve to latissimus dorsi from the posterior cord of the brachial plexus. Regarding action of the trapezius does everything. Okay, elevation, depression, retraction of the scapula or of the shoulder region. So the upper fibers elevation, the lower fibers depression, the middle fibers retraction. Okay, again, action of trapezius. This is the trapezius, upper fibers, middle fibers, lower fibers, and this is the insertion, clavicle, acromion, spine of the scapula. Upper fibers, okay, elevation, depression, retraction. Upper fibers, elevation of the shoulder. Lower fibers, depression of the shoulder. Middle fibers, retraction. And actually, trapezius and the serratus anterior rotate the scapula or rotate the arm to raise the arm above the head. Regarding the deep layer, three muscles. The first one, levator scapulae, and then rhomboid minor and rhomboid major. The three muscles take origin from the vertebral column. You don't have to know the details of the origin. They are inserted into the medial border of the scapula, the dorsal lip. Levator scapulae from the upper angle to the crest of the spine. Rhomboid minor opposite the crest of the spine. And rhomboid major is inserted into the medial border from the crest from the spine till the inferior angle. Regarding the nerve supply, dorsal scapular nerve or nerve to rhomboids from C5. Regarding the action, levator scapulae, of course, elevation of the shoulder, and rhomboids, retraction of the shoulder. So levator scapulae, elevation, rhomboid minor, retraction, rhomboid major, retraction of the shoulder. Again, action of the three muscles. Okay, levator scapulae, here, elevation of the shoulder. Okay, elevation of the shoulder. Rhomboid minor and rhomboid major, retraction of the shoulder. Then the serratus anterior. This is the serratus anterior. which forms the medial wall of the axilla. Okay, talk about the origin from the upper atrium's insertion into the medial border of the scapula, the ventral lip of the medial border. Nerve supply, the long thoracic nerve from C5, 6, and 7. And the action of serratus anterior is protraction of the scapula, protraction pushing the scapula forward, like this pushing, and upward rotation of the scapula to raise the arm above the head. So the action of the serratus anterior is pushing, okay, protraction, pushing the scapula forward, okay, and rotation of the scapula, okay, upward rotation of the scapula to raise the arm above the head. Then we'll talk about the nerve lesion. So action of serratus anterior, the first action is protraction, pushing movement, push the scapula forward, okay, pushing movement. The second action is rotation, elevation of the arm above the head, rotation of the scapula with the trapezius. So the action, rotation of the scapula above the head from 90 degrees to 180 degrees with the trapezius. This is the trapezius pulling the scapula upward, and this is the serratus anterior pulling the inferior angle of the scapula outward. Okay? So rotation of the scapula to raise the arm above the head. Regarding paralysis of serratus anterior, it is due to lesion or injury of the long thoracic nerve, C5, 6, and C7. It will cause, okay, it may occur during breast surgery operation, and it will cause winging of the scapula, pushing the scapula backward, or pulling the scapula backward, winging of the scapula. This deformity is due to injury of the long thoracic nerve and the paralysis of the serratus anterior. 10 muscles of the shoulder region. Muscles of the shoulder are 6. This is the first one, deltoid. Second one, here, from here to the bicipital groove, teres major. And the rotator cuff muscles. The 4 rotator cuff muscles. They read 6. Supraspinatus. Infraspinatus. Teres minor and the subscapularis. Note that subscapularis is inserted into the lesser tuberosity. Supraspinatus, infraspinatus, and the teres minor are inserted into the greater tuberosity of the humerus. Therefore, the rotator cuff muscles are the muscles which are inserted into the lesser tuberosity and greater tuberosity of the humerus. So again, let us talk about the supraspinatus because it is a very important muscle, although very small muscle. It takes origin from the supraspinous fossa, inserted into the greater tuberosity, the upper impression. It is supplied by the suprascapular nerve, and the action is initiation of abduction of the arm from 0 to 15 degrees. So this muscle is very important in initiation of abduction of the arm. Infraspinatus, infraspinous fossa, greater tuberosity, okay, and it is supplied by the suprascapular nerve also. It is lateral rotators, lateral rotator, teres minor from the lateral border of the scapula to the lower impression. Teres minor is supplied by the axillary nerve, and it is also lateral rotator. Subscapularis, from the subscapular fossa, inserted into the lesser tuberosity, supplied by upper and lower subscapular nerves, and the action is adduction and the medial rotation. And of course, it is one of the rotator cuff muscles. Then let us talk about the deltoid muscle. Talk about the origin. From the clavicle, from the acromion, from the crest of the spine, okay? Similar to the insertion of the trapezius. It is inserted into the deltoid tuberosity. It is supplied by the axillary nerve, and the action of the deltoid, actually the most important fibers are the middle fibers. The middle fibers abduct the arm from 15 to 90 degrees. Anterior fibers, flexion and medial rotation. Posterior fibers, extension and lateral rotation. Then tear is measured. Tear is measured from the lower third of the lateral border of the scapula to the lateral lip of the bicipital groove. It is supplied by the lower subscapular nerve. Since it is inserted into the bicipital groove, so the action is adduction and medial rotation, and it is coming from the back, so extension of the shoulder joint. Regarding axillary nerve lesion, axillary nerve lesion will lead to paralysis of the deltoid muscle. So we'll talk about the causes and the deformity. The causes of the axillary nerve lesion, the first cause is dislocation of the shoulder. Second one is fracture of the surgical neck of the humerus. The deformity is flat shoulder. This flat shoulder is due to paralysis of the deltoid muscle and the atrophy of the deltoid muscle. Then we'll talk about the rotator cuff muscles. Rotator cuff muscles are four muscles. Sits, S-I-T-S. Supraspinatus, infraspinatus, teres minor, and subscapularis. Okay, supraspinatus from the supraspinous fossa to the upper impression of the greater tuberosity, infraspinatus, infraspinous fossa to the middle impression, teres minor from the lateral border to the lower impression. Supraspinatus and infraspinatus are supplied by the suprascapular nerve. Teres minor by the axillary nerve. Supraspinatus is very important muscle in initiation of abduction of the arm from 0 to 15 degrees. The action of the rotator cuff muscles is to keep the head of the humerus in the glenoid cavity for stability of the shoulder joint. So they stabilize the shoulder joint by fixing the head of the humerus in the glenoid cavity. Actually, the stability of the shoulder joint depends mainly on the rotator cuff muscles. Then let us talk about abduction of the arm. Abduction of the arm from 0 to 180 degrees. So from 0 to 90 degrees and from 90 degrees to 180. From 0 to 90 degrees, it is the movement of the humerus in the glenoid cavity. From 90 to 180 degrees, it is a rotation of the scapula. Movement of the humerus by two muscles. From 0 to 15 by supraspinatus. From 15 to 90 by the deltoid muscle. And from 90 to 180, rotation of the scapula by the trapezius and serratus anterior. So we have four muscles abducting the arm from 0 to 180. From 0 to 90, supraspinatus and the deltoid. From 90 to 180, trapezius and serratus anterior. Again, abduction of the arm. From 0 to 15, this is initiation by supraspinatus. From 15 to 90, by the middle fibers of the deltoid muscle. And from 90 to 180, okay, raising the arm above the head by the trapezius and the serratus anterior. Therefore, paralysis of the supraspinatus lead to inability to initiate abduction. Paralysis of the deltoid muscle will lead to inability to abduct the arm from 15 to 90 degrees. There are some spaces between the muscles in the shoulder region, quadrangular space and two triangular spaces. This is the humerus. This is the teres minor. Okay, teres major and long head of triceps. This is the quadrangular space. Triangular space 1, triangular space 2. Let us see here. This is the humerus. Okay, there is minor. There is major. Long head of triceps. This is the quadrangular space. Triangular space 1, triangular space 2. Look here. This is the humerus. There is minor. There is major. Long head of triceps. This is the quadrangular space. This quadrangular space transmits axillary nerve and posterior circumflex humeral vessels. Axillary nerve, posterior circumflex humeral vessels. This triangular space transmits circumflex scapular artery. This triangular space transmits the radial nerve and the profunda brachii artery. Again, this is the quadrangular space transmits axillary nerve and the posterior circumflex humeral artery. This triangular space transmits circumflex scapular artery, and this triangular space transmits radial nerve and the profunda brachii artery. This is the axillary nerve in the quadrangular space. This is the radial nerve in the triangular space, and this is the axillary nerve related to the surgical neck of the humerus. And thank you very much. Best wishes and good luck.